To get back to the rendering pipeline, our simplified view is this. The application sends a triangle to the GPU. The GPU determines where the triangle's vertices are on the screen, including the z-depth. Each pixel inside the triangle is shaded. If the pixel passes the z-buffer test, it is then saved to the image and displayed at the end of the frame. Modern GPUs have parts of the pipeline that are programmable. The transform to screen part of the pipeline is done by what is called a vertex shader. This programmable element, essentially a little computer, processes each vertex of the triangle. The vertex shader uses information provided to it to manipulate each vertex in some way. For example, the color of the triangle at this point could be computed, or the vertex's position could be modified, if, for example, you wanted to have an object inflate or explode. One operation the vertex shader always does is to output a location of the vertex on the screen. The second half of our modern GPU pipeline we represent here by two stages, triangle setup and the fragment shader. Triangle setup uses the three screen locations generated by the vertex shader for an incoming triangle. This forms a triangle in screen space. Each pixel covered by part of the triangle has what is called a fragment generated for it. This process is called scan conversion. The fragments generated are sent to the fragment shader. Well, if you used Microsoft's DirectX API, this is called the pixel shader instead. The fragment shader is provided information by the triangle being processed. Similar to the vertex shader, the programmer can also feed in any other data desired. The fragment shader runs a program that typically outputs a color and a z-depth value. This z-depth value is then tested against the z-buffer, as usual. If the surface is visible, the color is saved for that pixel. The shader pipeline is designed to compute the color at each pixel that the surface covers. That's its ultimate purpose, after all, creation of an image. Everything done in the pipeline comes down to this. How do we efficiently calculate this color? That's what the last half of this unit is about, materials and how they work. Given a material and some incoming light, you want to compute a color coming off that material.